All learning is remembering. When the polarity of your perception reverses, what you once thought of as an external world, you experience as the projection of your own dimensional vision. The premises that support your thinking are fundamentally altered. Figure and ground are reversed. Creature and environment are experienced as components of a single system. Indeed, it could not be otherwise. Observer and observed, figure and ground, cannot be separated. Each projects the other, and conforms to its contours, as closely as the ocean to the shore. Distinctions are recreational. In the currents of eternal life, they are emphasized at certain times, and de-emphasized at others, but they are never absolute. Lover and beloved are forever unified at the deepest levels. Distinctions serve to further develop the great masterpiece of inhabitable art that this universe is, and is always becoming, and they magnify the means of enjoying it. In the fallen state, you have functioned in reverse. You have taken your direction from what you perceived as an external world. Since that world did not exist, your creative power was mischanneled into creating a world that conformed to your illusions. In healthy function, this cannot occur. Your creature/environment understanding, your self-understanding, does not enter you from without, but rises up like a spring from within your heart. When your love for God spills over into graceful unified function, your use of the human mind becomes extensive and complete. On the channels of inner being, you receive the informing pulsation of the life force directly, no longer filtering it through egoically structured thought. My love becomes your love, and flows out into your environment with such force of expression that no construct, habit, or concern from the old historical fiction is able to enter you from without. When you love fully, without reservation, you feel, sense, and move within love's rhythmic current. The definition songs that pulse through your soul are free to call out the excellence of your surroundings. As you allow love to flow out from within you, you will remember things that you had forgotten about these physical realms. You will remember that everything has a soul song that is at once its definition and its expression. You will recognize all that lives in this blessed biosphere, and much more besides, as objectifications of your own melodies, and consciously then, you will sing the songs of distinction, the songs that call forth all that appears in this planetary environment. A sculptor can always use hammer and chisel, but if she can sing the right songs, the songs that speak the true names, the songs that go to the very heart of the matter with which she works, she can inspire that matter to participate intelligently in its own development and recreation. The matter will do more than conform to her conceptions, it will surpass her conceptions with ideas and suggestions of which she had never dreamed. The materials themselves inform the conscious artisan of the implicit possibilities, biological and otherwise, inherent within them. Even the greatest artist does not perceive as well as the materials with which he works. Even before you experience the psychological process, you can communicate with the minerals and elements of the earth. When you stop seeing them as separate and inferior to yourself, when you regard them as equal, but distinct, expressions of the matter/energy continuum. When you collaborate with your ego, entwining your respective views in the flow of an integral life, you can go to the very heart of every creature, every stone, every plant, every ocean wave, every starfish on the beach, and you can sense if it is happy, if it is complete, if it has developed to the pinnacle of its desired intention, or if it has potential that yet seeks release. You can stimulate that release, and assist that potential into temporal and spatial form. And wherever you choose to turn your attention, it will be welcome. Just as a forest rises to greet the sun, reaching up and welcoming its light, its energy, its love, you will find the minerals and elements of the earth rising up to welcome you. So the earth has always favored, and always will favor, those who are in love. In the awakened state, you perceive not only the physical world. You see also the spirit world, the world of potential and shimmering design. When you perceive conceptions that have crystallized ethereal design patterns in the currents of universal awareness, conceptions of yet unmanifest physical possibilities, you will be able, should you choose, to guide the molecular flow of appropriate substance into those designs. Through you, the visions of eternity will manifest in these realms of structured light. The Earth's joy at engaging with one incarnate, who sees with the vision of the Creator, is the joy of a lover rushing to meet her beloved. In many cases, your presence and your vision will be all that is required to inspire the appropriate substances. When the energy of your attention shines upon a specific design pattern, all that is required for its dimensionalization will flow into it with the ease and the efficiency of a sapling rising to greet the sun. Molecular substance is eager to flow into the patterns that will release its potential, eager to enter our designs, your designs, the designs of the consciousness who created a universe with these very possibilities in mind. Through the spirit world that surrounds and interpenetrates all things, you have brought forth this present season of beings and creatures upon this world. But when your creative intentions are channeled through awakened human consciousness, you can introduce more specific detail and more effectively guide terrestrial development. With conscious human participation, an advanced order of creation is possible, an order that will build upon what has appeared through former creative ages, taking all things to a higher developmental octave, to a higher order of beauty. The Earth can be brought to the perfection of her potential only through this second type of creation, only through eternal beings incarnate in human form, who know universal intentions as their own. You are one of the eternal beings with whom I share this purpose. Your human body is a composite of intricate and interwoven biological systems, some of which are designed to focus creative energies. These systems can direct the creative streams of focused attention with far more precision and accuracy than is possible from a disincarnate seat of awareness. When human egos welcome the consciousness of their eternal counterparts back into their human forms, and again cooperate with their own forgotten purposes, the historical intermission will at last be over, and the creative unfoldment of this world will resume. The Earth will bear much greater fruit than what has appeared historically, for through the human family, an entirely new cycle of creation will commence, a second creative movement, as distinct from the first. As a solo is distinct from a fully orchestrated symphony. Awakened, you are a master artisan, a musician singing the songs of praise that Father Star sings to Mother Earth. You will remember the songs that call forth root and tree, flower and cloud, leaf and stone, but more than this, for disincarnate spirit can evoke these things without human help, you will remember how to sing the songs that only awakened humans can sing, songs that will bring metals up from the ground, songs that will attract elements, minerals, materials, from across great distances, through the power of their true names. You will sense the vibrational frequencies, or channels, upon which each plant, each animal, each mineral functions. You will recognize the energy currents upon which they live and move. Awakened, you know your human circuitry for what it is, a system of empathy, representation, and creation, designed to regulate and evoke biology. You know that the systems and creatures, indeed all aspects of this active biosphere, have corollaries in the human body. Within yourself, you will activate the glands and organs that correlate to each of the Earth's animal, vegetable, and mineral species. You will feel their frequencies and know their uses. You will sing the songs that will cultivate the garden that is this world, songs to nourish and fulfill her forms of life, songs to regulate her climate, to guide her rainfall. You will remember the songs of wind and rain, songs of the seasons, songs of evocation and blessing, songs of love, songs that will assist the Earth in maintaining a fertile biosphere, a task she now does alone, often in spite of, instead of assisted by, humankind. And within you will arise the songs that will bring forth new creatures, species to bridge the life forms of today with the life forms that will carry biology to the stars.